Yo.
What up?
Hello.
Welcome back to the Podoxical Podcast, or the Podoxical Cast, whatever you want to call it. We are suffering network quality problems right now. Sorry about the noise. It's a necessary evil. Yeah. So, we are joined with a new guest. He's not that new for me, but he might be new for the viewers out there. Don't know why this is showing my taskbar. Cade.
Yeah, it's me.
Yeah, it's Mr. Black and Blue.
Niggy. Yeah, Black and Blue.
Yeah. So, yeah, how's everybody been?
I'm fucking disappointed.
Fuming.
That's what I am, mate. I'm fuming. I'm fuming at everyone in the video game industry. And in the whole world.
In the whole world. Sounds like we got a narcissist. How do you say that? I don't know.
Narcissist.
Yeah, see, there we go.
Narcissist?
Ooh, I think so. I don't know. Whoa. Hold on. It's lagging. It's because if you're watching, folks, it's like delayed because it's streaming to my Xbox One. So just bear with us. So we got a fair bit to talk about. I mean, in the last week in the gaming world, a lot of things have been happening.
Gaming. So,
yeah, gaming. Gaming.
Game. Sorry, isn't it?
Well, don't be homophobic now, alright? I don't want to get blacklisted on YouTube, right?
Jesus.
Dude, we're just gamers. We're not murderers.
I'm just going to have to pause the game real quick. Yeah, so. How about Bethesda's Fallout first, huh? I think we should start off with that.
I think it's fucking disgraceful, to be honest with you.
Fucking dog shit.
Yeah, the company's pretty much just in the dirt.
It is going down the drain.
I don't think they're in the skylight by anyone's definition, so.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a famous man, Mr. Leahy or John Dunsworth, he had a saying. The more you hold on to the shit rope, wait, I can't remember how it goes. It's like, the more you hold on to the shit rope, the harder you slip, or something like that. It's like they're holding on, but in the way they're holding on, they're just making everything way more worse. I see it as like, I don't know, I got $300 edition. I'm not paying $400 for a game that, well, was probably the worst game of 2018, so.
Yeah, practically.
Which is still being listed at prices up to $80, mind you.
Yeah. I don't think the digital stores care, but you can really see, like, the difference when you go into, like, an actual, like, store. The prices will be cut way down, but digital, you think it's normal. I think that's a little deceptive. Like, I think people should know if it's a new game and it's already been, the prices have been lowered. I think that's when they should get the vibe like, oh, this mustn't be a very good game for what the norm is today, nowadays.
I don't think any people that aren't just Fallout fans really paid any attention to the game. It's only the players that have kept it alive that have made their own fun in the game, because to be honest, it's not a very fun game in its current state.
No, I played it like probably a few times, and that was about it. So yeah, it's not very
$300 for a few hours of fun.
But yeah, it wasn't worth it. Ah, oh, fuck's sakes, my fucking New Vegas is all over the place. It's really delayed. I'm just gonna change HDMI so I can see what I'm actually doing.
Interesting.
Yeah, so we got more to talk about, don't worry. Modern Warfare. What's you guys' take on it? Or your guys' take on it? From what you've seen so far.
I heard that it's good.
Yeah.
Like story, narrative wise. I don't have the game. Like the
Well, I don't have the game either, but what I'm most intrigued by is the cross-play system and how they've got skill-based matchmaking rather than just put you in with a bunch of noobs, you know what I mean? So it's like, I reckon they're really innovating the shooting genre just by those little changes.
Yeah, I can kind of see what you mean there. I mean, I've played it. I like it. I think, in my opinion, it's been the best Call of Duty since 2012. So that's 7 years. So it's a good achievement.
That was Black Ops 2, wasn't it?
Yeah. It's a good achievement for Infinity Ward. And it's a good achievement for the Call of Duty community as a whole, I think. Because it's been so long since we've really had a game where we could sink our teeth into without getting bullshit rammed down our throats. Or just a bad game in general. So... that's the way
I don't know what you're talking about, mate. Robot females are like the best thing ever that's happened to the genre.
Oh, yeah. Of course. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, so, what's the next DLC? What's Happy Trails Expedition? I forgot what that is. Do you know?
No idea.
Happy Trails Expedition. I think that is the Joshua Graham one.
Hmm. Might have to play that. Big Mountain. So, what else can we talk? So I played it. I mean, the big problem about Modern Warfare right now is campers. Some of the map that I feel like when they made the maps, they just like done whatever. They didn't care about. I don't think they paid much attention to how the game really worked when they made the maps. I think they might have made the maps before they made the mechanics and everything, because it just doesn't match up at all. It's really weird. It's really hard to explain if you haven't played it, but you'll know what I mean if you do. So, we're in combat. Shit.
Well, to bring up something totally out of that picture, what about the Outer Worlds?
The Outer Worlds, fantastic looking game. I don't know if it's quite the spiritual successor to New Vegas, but I hope so.
It's like... I don't have it, but I get... Everyone knows that iFunny is like the best news and criticism
obviously
app ever.
Yes. Yeah.
This guy said... what was it? It says here... The game is fantastic, a little bit short, but it's nothing like New Vegas, but I appreciate how it's a new game that is just inspired by the roots of, like, what their game has made.
Yeah, I think that's...
It's not exactly New Vegas.
We'll see.
Yeah. And if we're going to be talking about spiritual successes, this wasn't on the list to talk about, but Back for Blood, that'll be coming out. I don't know when it's coming out, but I hope it's going to be good. I heard that... I heard that it's... They've changed the way... Like, usually when you play, you know, you've got three males, one female. They've changed it so you have two female, two male. I don't know. I don't know if I care, if I don't care. It's hard to say. Because I don't know if that's going to ruin the whole dynamic of, like, the game, or... What do you think?
I mean, I don't know, it's okay.
Yeah. I don't know, I kind of feel like that, yeah, it could be a problem, but I don't know. I don't know, so... I hope it's not a problem.
Who was developing that game again? Was it still Valve?
No. But we're gonna be talking about Valve actually. I cannot hit this. Okay, there we go. Yeah, so we'll be talking about but it's developed by the people that made the first game, so what's that? Turtle Rock Studios. And they were called Valve South. That's how big their deal was. So yeah, interesting stuff. But now we're talking about that. How about the Dying Light? And
No. If no one doesn't know, there was like this thing of like to be honest, we probably just read it wrong, but like,
yeah,
it was Dying Light mixed with Left 4 Dead 2. Dying Light's like my most favorite zombie game, and we thought it was gonna be like
a huge like game, like Dying Light 2. Some shit, but
turns out they just added like the weapons. Well, only three daily weapons.
That
no one's like the guitar, the pan.
Yeah, that's. I mean, it's kind of disappointing, but it's good news in a way because Valve hasn't mentioned. Because this has to be official, because obviously it's Dying Light that's making this. Valve must have had some say in it, obviously. No matter what. Must have had some say in letting them even use the name Left 4 Dead. So that means...
Which could relate to the new Left 4 Dead game. Like Back 4 Blood. I'm not sure if they have anything to do with it, with the publishing or something, but...
I hope so, but it just at least we've got something from Valve. Like, the last update for Left 4 Dead was like in 2013, so it's been a long time since we've heard anything. So in that regards, it's kind of exciting, in my opinion. Even though it's not much, but we haven't got anything for like 10 years. There hasn't been a Left 4 Dead in 10 years this year. So. Yeah, that's the
just
way
the result. That's just the CSGO result, realistically.
Yeah. I don't know, I haven't really played CSGO much. I don't think I even played it. Seen people play it a lot.
It's free, I think.
It's free?
Apparently.
Yeah, they made it free to play, I think it was about 6 months ago.
Oh, I wonder why.
But no, but now there's just a bunch of hackers on like the... So unless you're playing comp or anything, it's just a bunch of hackers and stuff.
Yeah.
Not even if you're playing comp, it's just like... Unless you're playing in those set up servers, I can't remember what they're called. You're pretty much just going to get a bunch of hackers in there.
I know you're going to go to the Northern Passage here. Okay. I would like to settle down. What's going on here? I'm just gonna pause the game real quick. So we thought we might want to talk about sports games and how they're getting bad as well. It's another thing
especially about. If you watch any content or any of the stuff for new WWE game, it is the fucking worst looking piece of 2019 game, just anything made I've ever seen. Like, it looks like some kids made it in a college class in about 2 months. It's like the worst thing I've ever seen.
So what company makes that again?
It's like, I know they're published by 2K, but I can't remember who makes it.
Yeah, well, I mean, all their games, they're going to crap. And, I don't know, I have a theory, but I don't know if there's any merit to it. But I could see, like, I'm sure people could see where I'm coming from. I think there might be a crash, like, probably not in probably the next 10 years, because it's got to get a lot worse than it is right now, obviously. But I feel as though like microtransactions and things in games are just going to get so bad that no one's going to give into it anymore. And I hope this happens. I hope no one ever gives into it. like to bad games in the future, but I just hope that they kind of have like a financial crash, and then indie games or indie publishers will come out. And but then again, you could think that could be end up like being a repeat, so we'll just have to see. But it's kind of a theory.
Yeah, well, it's like even games like Fortnite, isn't even making as much revenue as it did when it first released.
Isn't it?
It's the revenue streams down by like 75% or something like that.
Goodness. I'm just going to look at a couple other things we could talk about here. We've gone over most of the things. But
we talk about all the streamers going over the Mixer.
Yeah, so what's the deal with that? I guess you know a bit about that.
I think they're just getting bored out, to be honest.
All the streamers, yeah. I hate that about companies. They're just... I don't know. It's like...
Well...
I mean, if you used to have a Twitch account, you wouldn't be complaining.
Yeah. I suppose, yeah, if you were the one getting
Twitch
the
money. Twitch went to
shit. What happened to Twitch? I know, I'm not very...
They're just really... They're just monetizing all the... cheeks on there, they're like showing their teats and stuff. It's just not good for the company.
Yeah, like a... I don't know, don't want to revive old drama and shit, but like a girl threw a cat, wasn't it? On stream?
Yeah.
I heard about it.
Probably been on YouTube, but yeah.
What about Mr. Beast planting 20 million trees?
That's interesting, actually. Pretty cool, actually.
I was watching something.
Do you think he really cares about the trees, or he just wants?
I think he generally cares, but he's in that position where he knows he's gonna get money for making anything. So he knew this was gonna get him a lot, but I kind of.
I don't know. It's a pretty interesting feat. Like. 20 million trees at the start, like January 1st, 2020.
They've already raised over 7 million, haven't they?
7.8 million right now, hang on.
Yeah, Elon Musk said he'd even donate a million, so... Sounds pretty mainstream already.
I was watching a thing on the Infographic Show about it, and if they do plant 20 million, that's going to be insane, because, I can't remember all the statistics, but it's going to, like, I don't know, I think it's going to do a lot good for the environment, just 20 million trees.
Well, it won't guarantee, like, it won't stop climate change.
No, but they actually think if we can plant so many trees, that it could actually put a major dent in climate change, or even stop it if we planted that many trees. That's what I heard on the Infographic Show, so if I'm wrong, you can go and carry on about that to them. So
Infographic,
yeah, you know them guys.
Oh yeah.
I don't know why I was really just watching it, but
I watch it just for like the survivor story type shit. They also have a Bronson.
Oh, yeah. Talking about Bronson, they probably won't... Well, they won't know this reference, but Martin Gang. Is it coming soon? Yes, it's coming soon. I don't have much to say about it. We had the first... Well... We had about half of the third episode done. Probably a bit over half. I'm probably under-exaggerating. I don't know if that's a good thing to encourage you guys or not, but...
Well, what did we have recorded?
Well, I can't say. I don't want to say.
I suppose that's a specific question of us.
We'll talk about it after, I guess. But, so it's coming. I don't know. It's just hard to get 8 people on now. People have jobs and... Well, only 2 people in the gang have jobs, but...
It's, yeah, but one works well, actually, one about fucking 30 hours away.
Yeah.
Distract.
So, yeah.
Point Blank coming soon though. Probably sooner than GTA. Probably sooner than the Red Dead series.
Yeah, I kind of want to transition to Point Blank. It'll be easy to record. But it's not my series, so you can tell them about it if you want.
I'm writing the script. It's mostly just a scripted thing instead of improvised.
Yeah.
Because I always want to... I guess I just don't have the resources for an actual TV show.
Yeah, well, obviously, yeah.
I always thought it would be cool to have a... Yeah. Always be cool to have a crime.
So, yeah, that'll be good. I hope it'll be good. I mean, the trailers, I thought, come out pretty good.
It'll be much easier to record, considering we'll have the Rockstar editor on our side.
Like, if it actually helps and catch up to what it likes. Problem might be syncing with the actual audio.
Yeah. That's a problem with the Martin gang just as much, I'm guessing. Probably, if not more. I don't know, syncing's harder when there's more cuts. So. Yeah. SCP, that's another thing I wrote down. And I'll think of a couple other things to talk about.
SCP.
So. Where do you think... When do you think, not where, do you think how dumb am I?
I mean... It would be cool to have... Record maybe this weekend.
Yeah.
Because I'm just going to say that it's a bitch to... Edit.
Also, I'd like to add that I do actually write a script for Martin Gang, but because there was 8 people, it was insanely hard to. I mean, it's just impossible. So,
what are we down to now? We're down to 7, right? But after time, we don't have everyone. So,
yeah. So it's just a bitch. I mean, I don't know. We'll figure it out. It'll be done.
Usually, it'll take a while. This isn't just exclusive to the Martin gang, but sometimes goes wrong. People just go crazy and wreak havoc.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Last time we didn't forgot to record. Last time we didn't have time to record a Martin gang video. At school the next day, it was all right just because of it. I swear to God.
Yeah, so I think we went over everything we could really talk about, but I'm not going to end it right now. I'm going to play a bit of New Vegas, so I'm going to change to H9 and see if it's synced up. Martin Gang vlog? Magic. Hell yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Paradox.
Well, I think we should. Vlog. I don't know. When should we show our faces? What subscriber amount do you think that'd be?
100.
100?
No.
100 would be too soon, I'd think. Even though it's a while away.
1,000?
We need to upload some more quality stuff if we really want to.
Well, as soon as we are eligible for monetization, how about that?
What are the eligibility requirements for that nowadays?
1,000?
Don't you need like 4,000 hours of viewage a year or something like that?
It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. Jesus Christ, this guy needs to calm down.
And he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip. Any future video game releases he's looking forward to?
Well, Dying Light 2. What else?
Cyberpunk.
Cyberpunk 20. Fallout second. That'll be another good one.
Fallout second. Why is it even called Fallout first? What is the reason?
I don't know if that's like a reference to Trump administration, or I don't know what the hell it's a reference to.
Like Fallout first. Maybe it's like the first to get the new juicy content or something.
Hell of fun, eh?
No, but it's $100-something a year. It's ridiculous.
Is this like, it's like Spotify Premium, but for Fallout?
Well,
Well, I mean, it's going to cost a bit more than bloody Spotify Premium. It's $100 if you want it for the whole year.
A month, they're $100 for a year. It's like, I don't know what they're getting at, and I don't know how many people are actually going to purchase it.
Not many. I hope not many. Yeah, better not be many.
I think
they haven't been doing as bad as people make it seem, but they're still updating the game regularly. But...
yeah, it's just not enough anymore.
People that got Fallout first actually are like getting griefed.
You serious?
Like,
yeah, because
it tells you if you have Fallout first.
When you have a private session open, which is main reason people are buying Fallout first, people on your friends list can just join without an invite, so it's not even really a private session.
Well, no, it's not, is it? No, that's stupid.
And people, one of the other main benefits from it is this thing called a scrap box. You can hold unlimited scrap in, because the normal thing in the game has a weight limit of about £500, I'm pretty sure. So, and people are reporting that it's deleting all their scrap, which sometimes people have been spending months to gather, and it's just disgraceful.
That ain't on.
But other than all that, the gaming industry's been pretty sound, waiting for new releases like they always are.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. There's like not much happens. I don't know. It's a pretty quiet industry, but it's not at the same time. Like, not many. It's not widespread public news, obviously, is it? But to us, it is. But I don't know. It's hard to explain.
And one thing I feel like isn't talked about enough is fucking Tom Clancy releases the same game every year, the Ghost Recon games.
Yeah, I know. It's a bit ridiculous.
I don't want to say Tom Clancy because I don't think he has anything to do with it.
But... no.
I think he's dead.
Yeah, I think Tom Clancy is dead. Yeah, rip. Rest in peace, Tom Clancy. If you're not dead,
what about
well,
rest in peace to Rip Torn?
To who?
Apparently, like, it's a military-based thing, but Rip he's, like, Torn. Not military, maybe.
I know, I've been hearing pretty bad things about, what's it called, buddy? Ghost Recon Wildlands 2 or whatever it was. What is it called? Something like that.
I don't know.
Breakpoint.
I've been hearing pretty bad things.
Yeah, there's just a lot of glitches with the game. That's one thing I dislike about yearly releases, which I feel like only one game company really gets the yearly release right, and that's Call of Duty, because they have multiple studios under the brand making it. But like individual companies that make the Ghost Recon games, they just need more time to develop a quality game.
Yes.
Alright, Fallout New Vegas. What's this? Is this? Oh, this is Honest Hearts. Alright. I guess I'll do Lonesome Road next. So what are we playing right now? Other than me.
I've just been browsing the social medias.
I'm playing GTA 5.
I see.
I just need money. I want money.
Oh wait, oh they got a Tommy gun?
That's something to talk about. How fucking boring Red Dead 2 is at the moment.
Oh, we forgot to talk about that. Yeah, it's boring. Liam still manages to play it every day.
It's easy to get money.
It's easy, yeah, it is easy to get money now. No doubt about that.
One thing that annoys me is I think they think they've done enough just releasing those, like, the Bounty Hunter and that stuff, and they don't feel like they have to release anything good for a while, and it's just like...
The only thing they really got to do is add a gun, and that's what will get everybody back.
I feel like something they could also do is random events, like weekly random events. Just to get people coming back to do something every week.
Also, a really weird thing happened to me with Fallout 3. I wanted to, if you just so happen to have the Fallout 3 downloadable, redeemable code with Fallout 4. I deleted the game because it wouldn't let me go onto it, and it disappeared. So what you got to do is you got to go and use the same code again, which shouldn't even be able to happen. So I don't know if that's just like how
my Fallout Xbox already knows. Yeah,
I feel like
says I have it installed,
Fallout's always had like problems with like the inner game itself, like the game. Oh, that's hard to explain.
It's just not compatible with so many different things. It's just
they're great games, but it's just they. I don't know. They didn't just quite get it right, which is a shame. But New Vegas.
Well, I actually just can't install the game at all.
I'm installing as we speak. What is it on? 63%.
It says I own this game, but I can't install it. So I'm just crying.
And guys, I don't know what they're saying in the game. So. Use that to watch, and I have no idea what's going on because I can't hear what's going on. So that's that.
Are we gonna call out the members of the Martin gang that are stopping us from producing?
Are we gonna call them out?
Yeah, call out.
I don't know.
Might have to fight him on the local pole undercut.
We might have to. Oh, someone's getting messed up.
What do you reckon about all these YouTubers boxing?
More power to them, I don't care. Do whatever you want. I'm all for it. What do you think?
I used to look up on YouTube drama all the time, but ever since 2018, like 2016, Leafy and all that shit. But,
whoa, what are we shooting at?
I mean, the man that should not be man.
Whoa. Whoa, boys.
But yeah, drama's boring now.
Yeah, it's getting pretty boring.
Speaking of drama, what do you reckon about Keemstar?
Ricky's dead.
The living legend.
Keemstar? What has he been in the news lately?
Yeah. Don't know, just Ace family raping someone apparently.
The Ace family?
No. Yeah. You got that way wrong.
I'm just faking on what I've heard.
Okay, so he's
Ace family. Apparently Dad cheated. Oh, it wasn't even cheating. It was having sex with other women, and his partner approved it. No, she approves it.
And why would? What?
She's cocking herself.
And then she turns around and says, "No, you can't do that."
No, that's not what happened.
Wait, what?
Is this fucking, this gay dude, like, I don't know his name, he's just gay in my eyes. That's probably offensive, but she'll be right. He says that apparently Ace family raped one of his friends, and then he was going to use it for money. And that's just it. I think.
Well, shit. Wait, who was the Ace family, you know? I forgot.
It's this, like, black guy and his Mexican wife or something. And they just record videos with their kid.
Interesting.
You know that meme of the people saying, acting like it's really cool that they're working a 9-to-5?
9-to-5? No. What is, like, from
like
the song?
Job.
I can't even remember how the song goes, but I know it's in the song.
A 9-to-5 is just a regular job.
Yeah, I know.
But I don't know. All the YouTube drama shit is just retarded.
I wish we didn't have to upload on this platform, but that's what it is. Until someone can make a better platform.
We'll have to start uploading VODs.
Yeah, well, I mean, until someone can upload, I don't know, it's just, I don't know, until
that's
they can make a
better
version.
Could do. If these podcasts get decently popular, or our channel gets, well, it's not really my channel, but your channel gets pretty popular, you could start uploading things like this on Twitch, like recording it on Twitch and then uploading the VOD to YouTube or something like that.
Yep. We could, yeah. But YouTube's still a pretty good option as it is right now, in my opinion.
Yeah, how are you gonna go about advertising the channel? Make a Twitter account or something?
I don't know. We could do actual advertisements in real life. In the real world, bro.
You walk around with a sign on the freeway.
Yeah, just sub or die, I don't know, something like that. Should be our motto, sub or die. It's a bit shit, but
I think that's illegal.
Sub or die. Illegal? I don't know, probably.
Death threat, isn't it? But should be right.
Yeah, I don't know, probably death threat. So, we got anything else to talk about? Because I'm going to keep it going for a little bit longer.
I can't think of anything specifically, but you can talk about anything really nowadays.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. I'm just going to play New Vegas. I'm not going to really commentate over it as much as I was. Was everybody supposed to die at the start of that thing?
What do you mean? Start of what?
The start of, what is it, arrival at Zion, or Zion.
What's Zion? I don't know what you're on about.
I didn't think that was supposed to happen. I was pretty surprised.
Like the old caravan crew just gets choked.
I just get shot.
Speaking of chokes, not just.
Speaking of chodes, mate.
Quite a few chodes on this YouTube platform.
Oh, yeah. Too many. Too many to count.
I'm probably going to go.
Alright. Got anything else, Gadlin?
Great having you, mate.
Oh, you're going soon, I mean.
Hold on. Yeah, I'm gonna go now, but before I leave, you could talk about, some political, because that's Trump's impeachment. Bam, there you go. Boom.
Alright, subscribe.
Not gonna happen, that's what I reckon.
No. I don't know, just talk about
Liam always gives great advice.
Fume. Yes.
What a wonderful topic.
Yes, that's exactly what we're going to talk about next.
Actually, what grinds your gears? There you go.
Alright, fair enough.
Alright, I'm heading out. Subscribe.
You first, yeah.
All right.
If you don't, kill yourself.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see you in the next one. Okay.
Yes.
What does grind our gears?
For me, people who just take everything too seriously.
It's a cancer to our society, I think, personally, right now. People take things too seriously. A joke isn't a joke anymore. In Eastern Virgin. Okay, whatever.
What about you?
Well, that's what I think, but I don't think Trump's going to get impeached. I know that.
Well, it's already pretty much too late for, I feel like, anything to happen. And I feel like
his term's almost over anyway.
Depends on who the Democrats put up. Because they'd have to put up, I reckon, the only thing that could beat Donald Trump is a black with no legs.
Yeah, I mean, Hillary, they said, oh, Hillary's going to win. No, she was nowhere near winning.
They'd have to get the minority of the minority.
Yeah. You can't have a minority looking after a majority. So they don't know how the majority feels.
What do you think about Donald Trump's not a majority? He's fucking rich ass.
Holy crap, is that a bear? Oh my god.
Yeah, boy.
Yeah. He just threw a freaking green gecko at me. He threw it at me.
You threw a fucking gecko? What a savage.
Yeah. It's like he... Wait, what? Oh, he's got some ammo for me.
What would a bear have fucking ammo?
No, I'm talking about this guy called Follows Chalk. He's like an American Indian or whatever he is, I don't know.
Follows Chalk. I think that's just a tribe or something that they're in.
Yeah. I don't know who I'm going to side. I don't know what the hell's going on, but
I'm pretty sure you can only side with... Actually, it's two people, but...
But you're not going to tell me because...
I can't remember what I did.
I can't remember.
Because I don't want to spoil it.
You can't remember it anyway, so yeah, it'll be fine.
I can. I already told you. Joshua.
Yeah, I know who Josh. Can't even talk. I'm not even going to bother.
What's the point of a podcast if you're not going to talk?
Nah, it's just jokes, jokes, joke, mate.
Yeah. We could talk about more is just American politics, because Australia is not very interesting.
No, not compared. I don't know. What do you? Other than the impeachment, I can't think of much.
How about Pokemon go to the Pulse?
To the what? Pulse? Okay. What are you even talking about? I don't even know. So.
Don't worry about it. But, do you reckon the Democrats really have a future in today's America?
Yeah, I think they will do, and they'll have even more of a future the way they're going. Sadly, in my opinion.
What an upset, though, Donald Trump beating out the rapist's wife.
Yeah, I don't know. I guess we'll just have to see. I just don't know. I don't even know if I'm entitled to say. Because we're Australian, I mean, doesn't it? Well, it's always just bled into our...
Well, I mean, that's just more fun.
It's chiseled into our heads anyway, really. Even though we're not from that country. Which is kind of odd. That's how, like, popular their country is, and it's just insane.
Yeah. But it's... We're really... got the better better stance on it, because we don't have a biased opinion or anything, because our families didn't really grow up in a really, in one of the parties like they do.
No.
So we can have more of a
calculated,
proper standpoint rather than biased.
I mean, I feel like most, I don't know, like, I know there's true conservatives over there as well, but I feel like most of them are just like, that's who their dad, that's the kind of vibe you get. I don't know.
I mean, all I've known in Australia is that the Labor are the better party.
Yeah, that's what my dad always said too.
But I can see, like, just at such a young age still, I can see all the benefits of every party.
Yeah, but all of them lie. It's just, it's always...
I feel like at the current state, the Liberal Party is probably the best, because of how they're more organised and they know what they're doing more.
They've been winning a lot lately too, so... I don't know when the last time Labor got in. I don't really care much about Australian politics anyway, but it's not my strong point.
It's not very interesting. They don't really do anything. No. Most of their stuff is just about hospital money for the different jobs and stuff.
Yeah.
Maybe that's why we find American politics so interesting, because they're more about world stuff, and we're really, Australia's really closed in when it comes to politics.
I feel like everything in the southern hemisphere doesn't matter as much. It's almost like, that's what it feels like to me. Like, New Zealand would be even more, like, not talked about, obviously, because their population is very small. Like, very small.
Well, the most popular thing that's happened there ever is probably that mosque attack.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if ever. I don't know. It's hard to say. But Australia, what do you think the most popular thing about Australia is?
Crocodile Dundee. No, I don't know. It'll be up there though, probably. It's one of the highest grossing movies ever.
What do you think's better, Crocodile Dundee 1, 2, or 3?
Gotta go with the original.
Oh, I gotta go 2. 2's just... I don't know.
Definitely not 3 though.
3 was... eh.
It's good, but... no, doesn't compete.
No, it's just like, because that was after he got his facial surgery as well, so just it didn't look right. It obviously wouldn't, because, you know, most of the time you look a lot.
Because it's not actually looking right, but...
No. But, yeah. That's what... This DLC is pretty good so far. I'm liking it. I think it's probably my favourite. Just the setting is pretty cool. Old Lonesome Road.
I'm playing Fortnite right now. I didn't even realise they added zombies back to the game.
Fortnite? You say zombies?
Yeah.
What do you mean, like, real dumb players?
I like, actually zombies. But one thing that I feel like was one of the worst moves in gaming history was they added bots to the game.
Yeah. I never really liked Fortnite, but...
It's taken out a lot of the enjoyment for me in recent times, because I just find myself in a lobby for like 50 people that are literally not people.
They're robots.
Robots are taking over. It all starts with Fortnite.
Yeah. I don't know, what do you think the future of AI is? It's another thing we can talk about. It's interesting.
I feel like they are going to be more and more involved in real, actual, like, things in people's lives. as the world goes on, but I don't feel like they're ever going to be what people are saying there. Like,
I hope
they're going to dominate the world and stuff. At least not in our lifetimes. I don't think it's possible.
Well, as someone said, anything can happen. I don't even know how that song goes. But I'm going to say it. Crashed scout bus. Oh, they took the long way down. This must be the Grand Canyon. That's pretty cool.
Oh, yeah, I think... Yeah, that's what it is, actually. I completely forgot about that. But, yeah.
What? The Grand Canyon?
I don't know. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't even... I forgot completely that it was even that. But, yeah, that's probably... Behind whatever that one is we're Lines going to provide, that is definitely my favourite DLC. I just like the characters.
You going to what?
Besides, what's that one? You go into this place called the Divide, where you gotta just wander around and do a bunch of this shit.
Mm.
I don't know, it's kind of confusing when you just explain it like that, but I don't have any other better way to explain it.
Yeah. That's okay.
But you can tell Bethesda's not doing well when you're playing a decade-old game. It's not even made by them, but...
Yeah. Published.
Doesn't mean anything. The only thing that's really the same is the engine that they use.
Yeah. Yes, yeah, the publish... Yeah, that didn't mean anything, because, I remember watching the documentary on the Bethesda Studios just before Fallout 76 dropped. And, they legit only had one person helping out. Obsidian.
And I'm pretty sure that was only a creative director type of thing. I don't think it was actually any of the developers or anything.
Yeah. I think the guy just said, like, oh, maybe this rather than this. I think that was the only thing that they ever really conversed.
Yeah. The only thing Bethesda really had to do with that game was not giving him hardly any time to make it and limiting what they wanted to do so much.
Yeah. I just wish they'd just give the rights to Fallout to Obsidian. Really?
The stock, like the value of the Fallout rights would have been, I'm assuming they've been decreasing tremendously since the release of these new games.
You'd think so.
Like Fallout 4 and Fallout 76. Because if you think about it, although Fallout 4 is the highest grossing game in Bethesda history, it's not a worthy Fallout installment.
No, it was alright, but I don't think it was...
The potential's all there, but the way that they changed so many of the core Fallout mechanics really, really just messed up with my opinion on the game.
Yeah.
And it really all started with Fallout 3, how they limited player choice and, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't think player choice was going to be a thing, but Obsidian kind of made it a thing, really.
Well, if you look back at the older Fallout games, the only reason people played them was because you had so much freedom.
Oh yeah, the old Fallout so too. Choice, but that was more Obsidian, obviously, back then as well.
Yeah, like Obsidian was a thing company made up of the old Fallout game, developers, I should say.
Yeah. So, I'm pretty sure, like, they like to stick to the West Coast, and Bethesda is more East Coast, which is nice.
Yeah, we'd like.
So, hopefully, there's another.
Well, they did make a game in Washington, so it's not really true.
What? Well, DC's on the water, isn't it?
But it's full West Coast, isn't it?
What? Washington, D.C. No, I don't. You thinking New Vegas? New Vegas is in the middle.
Wait. What's the capital of America? The capital state.
The state, the capital, like as in Maryland. Maryland's the capital state.
I don't know what I'm on about, to be honest. I don't really know anything about American geography except for where the NBA teams come, state cities are located.
Well, good that I know a little bit. I don't know everything, but I know enough. So, yeah, Maryland's on the East Coast. I don't... It's like... They put it there... I don't know. They put it there because... it could have had something to do with the Civil War. Because, like, I'm pretty sure the South side was for the South and the North side was for the North. Like, because... I don't know. It had something to do with that. Anyway, I think we'll wrap it up here in a minute, or maybe in a few minutes.
Got to think of an ending topic.
Yeah.
I don't know. Go out with a bang.
Don't know what it could be.
Maybe we probably should have ended with the future of like the Martin Gang and all those things, but you could end it. A good way to end this, I reckon, would be talking about the future of the podcast.
Future of the podcast, yeah, that's a good one. Every week, one's going to come up. So, if you enjoy this kind of stuff, make sure you subscribe, like, comment, share. Be nice. Yeah, I'm probably going to end it here in a second. So this is how it's going to work. Next week it's going to be on PC. It will be a bit more edited. And then every 2 weeks is on the Xbox. So that'll be me, Liam, and Caden. On PC it'll be me, Liam, and Connor. So hopefully you guys will get used to that.
We'll be able to have guests from like that are in the Martin Gang and stuff every couple of weeks.
Yeah, that too. That'd be. That's something we should do. Yeah. I'll have all the colours. Maybe everyone, but that it might get a bit hectic. So maybe not.
Not in one episode, I don't reckon.
No. So yeah, I think we should end it up here. We'll wrap it up. All right. Yeah, we gotta wrap it up. So thanks for tuning in. Hope to see you next week.
Turn on notifications.
Yeah, turn on notifications. Make sure you put it on all what is it? All content? I don't know. Because subscriptions don't mean anything anymore. And YouTube done that for a reason. So...